How good exactly are detox diets or cleanses, and are they actually worth doing? Well, today we're going to learn a bit more about them, what the actual science says, and how I personally rate them on a scale between 0 to 10 PicFit points. Now, detoxes and cleanses have been all the rage for quite some time now, despite receiving continuous pushback from the scientific community. To be upfront, there's just not much in the realm of scientific evidence to support the supposed benefits of detox diets. And in a way, it seems that people who are pro-detox and cleanses kind of rely on just feels and vibes rather than any measurable benefits. Now, the reason for the lack of evidence largely comes down to the fact that there's no one detox diet out there, and detox companies can't seem to agree on what foods are best. Some allow eating only fruits and veggies, while some actually ban certain fruits and veggies. Others ban almost all protein sources, while others are actually protein rich. And of course, many companies also require you to purchase and consume their own little special juices, pills, and shakes. One company even requires you to consume their juice and nothing else. So, unsurprisingly, it's hard to research something with so much inconsistency across the board. And inconsistencies also expand to what exactly these diets are supposedly detoxifying from our bodies. Some claim to detoxify heavy metals, others claim to detoxify processed food waste, and others claim to remove synthetic chemicals like BPA. Some even claim to cleanse certain diseases. But again, there's simply no evidence showing these diets can detoxify anything. And really, we gotta give our bodies a bit more credit. Organs like our livers and kidneys have evolved to be highly effective in managing, filtering, converting, and excreting many potentially dangerous substances. It's not a perfect system, of course, but it's still pretty darn great. But if we really want to be more proactive about detoxification, then perhaps we should do something that's actually scientifically supported. One is to simply exercise more, because sweating can also eliminate a good deal of toxins. And if we want to take things even further, then we should step into a sauna, because some studies suggest that sweat produced in saunas excretes even more toxins than sweat from exercise. Just make sure you properly hydrate. Now, it might seem like everything discussed so far is painting detox diets in a pretty bad light, and that's because it is. And even though there's not a lot of research on specific detox diets, there are research reviews in 2015 and 2022 that analyzed these diets in a general sense. Both came to very similar conclusions, and that is that there's, again, no compelling evidence to support the use of detox diets. But they also pointed out potential dangers to these diets, since some of these diets, which are supposed to improve our health, ironically provide very little nutritional value. It might also be a potential risk to consume any proprietary detox juices and supplements, since they often go completely unchecked. In fact, there was a case in Spain where many people experienced severe illnesses, including one death after consuming proprietary Epsom salts from a cleansing program because the salts were accidentally prepared with the wrong compound. Overall, both reviews concluded that, based on its current standing, detox diets should be discouraged. And now, with all that said, how exactly would I personally rate detox diets or cleanses? Well, with the lack of data and basically everything else, I give detox diets a solid 1 PicFit point out of 10. Now, the only thing saving detox diets from being an absolute zero is the fact that I do think it's a good idea to promote using nutrition to potentially eliminate dangerous toxins and improve our health. The thing is, based on some preliminary evidence, certain nutritional components might indeed carry detoxifying properties. Citric and malic acids, for example, both common in fruits, are associated with reduced levels of aluminum. Chlorella from algae is associated with reduced levels of lead and mercury. And even coriander has been associated with reducing cadmium. So it'll be great if we keep seeing more research developed in this area. That said, we don't need detox diets to take advantage of these potential benefits. And if these diets do end up causing more harm than good, then we're best to skip them entirely. Now, if you made it this far, please, please let me know what you think about this whole ratings video format. I really want to give this format a shot, since it kind of presents health and fitness content in a different light. Not all things are so cut and dry in fitness, you know, because it depends, so rating things might be a good idea. In this case, it was a bit more cut and dry, but if you have certain topics you want to see discussed in this format, please let me know that as well. Other than that, if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a cleansing thumbs up and share it with your detox-loving friends. Subscribe for more and let me know what you think in the comments. As always, thank you for watching, and don't forget to get your protein.